Welcome back to the Gridiron Expert. We're continuing our SEC football predictions today, and our next team, the Kentucky Wildcats.
At first I didn't think that I was cut enough to bleed. Then I saw my secrets getting swallowed by the sea.
Kentucky made a bowl game for the first time since 2010 last season. Mark Stoops has done a great job turning around this program over his 5 years at the school. This year, he has Kentucky with a lot of higher expectations with 17 returning starters, including 8 on offense and 9 on defense. Kentucky fans can actually get excited about football season instead of waiting until basketball season. So they're going to have a lot to look forward to, I think, for Kentucky Wildcat football. They opened up the season at Southern Miss. If you remember last year, Kentucky actually lost at home to Southern Miss in the season opener. That was with a better quarterback at Southern Miss. I think Kentucky also didn't really know who they were at that point. Now, Stephen Johnson didn't come in as quarterback until later on in the season. That's who their quarterback's going to be this year. So I think they're going to go on the road and beat Southern Miss. That's not going to be an easy game, though. They are one of the top teams in the Conference USA, but I'm going to give them the win there. Eastern Kentucky, a couple years ago, maybe it was last year, they had to go to overtime to defeat Eastern Kentucky. So not another pushover game, but Kentucky needs to get in their head that these games are easy wins. They need to get up by a lot and have it stay that way. But I think they're going to get the win against Eastern Kentucky. I'll give them that. So 2-0 compared to 0-2 last year to start, so that's a complete turnaround. At South Carolina, don't think that's going to be a win for Kentucky. I think Carolina is definitely a lot better of a team with their returning starters, and I like Bentley at quarterback. Will Muschamp's doing a great job turning around things there, and I think they're going to lose at Carolina. So 2-1, but then Florida, who I have picked to win the SEC East, so do a lot of other people. I think it's between Florida and Georgia. I think Kentucky will beat Florida at home. They have not beaten Florida in 30 years, so I think they're going to be very excited for this game with a lot of promise to the season. 30-year losing streak to Florida. It's at home. A couple years ago, they came close to beating Florida. That game went to 3 overtimes. I feel that this is going to be the game they finally break through and upset the Gators at home. And trust me, they will be storming the field at that one. And then Eastern Michigan, a team that's improved in the MAC, contenders there. I think they have 16 returning starters at Eastern Michigan, including their quarterback, who's very good, but I think Kentucky will get the win there. So Kentucky opens up the season 4-1 with a key win over Florida, and they're kind of towards the top of the SEC East right now. Then they get Missouri at home. I like that game at home. I'm going to give them a win there. So 5-1 going into the bye week. The only problem is this last stretch of the season here, these last 6 games is where it gets really tough. Half of them are on the road against some of the better teams in the SEC, or better than Kentucky at least, Mississippi State, Vandy, and Georgia. At Mississippi State, last year Kentucky won a thriller at home against Mississippi State, 40-38, but it's at Mississippi State. I like Nick Fitzgerald. Kentucky gets the loss there. And then Tennessee, Kentucky gave Tennessee a fight last year at Neyland. Tennessee has to come to Kentucky, but I'm actually going to give Kentucky a loss here. This is one of those toss-up games that I've been talking about for other teams. This is one I really struggle with. But I feel like Tennessee will probably be the better team just later on in the season. So that's another loss for Kentucky. But if Kentucky were to win this game, they'd have to carry a bunch of momentum into the season or later on in the season. Ole Miss at home, I like that. I've talked about Ole Miss and how they really don't have much to play for this season. That's going to be really key. Now they've got the whole Houston Nutt controversy, how he's filing a lawsuit. So it's just Ole Miss is a mess right now. And the fact that they're a young team and have so many distractions off the field, I'm actually going to give Kentucky a win here for that. So, but Ole Miss, I think, will be better next year for sure. At Vanderbilt and at Georgia, 2 very tough games, very good offenses. Georgia especially will have a very good defense. I'm actually going to give Kentucky a loss for both of those games, unfortunately, for the Wildcats. That's really going to hurt. I mean, that's 4 losses there in their last 5 games. And, I mean, like I said, if they can upset Tennessee, that'd be huge. Maybe Vanderbilt, but I'm not high on Vanderbilt, but I feel that they will be able to pull up a few upsets here and there. And then Louisville, remember last year Kentucky went on the road and upset Louisville and Lamar Jackson. This year Louisville gets Lamar Jackson back, but they have to travel to Kentucky. Kentucky tends to play well against Louisville every year because it's such a big rivalry game. And I'm giving Kentucky the win over Louisville at home, which will give the Wildcats a 7-5 record to finish the season. It's actually the same record they had last season, but I think it'll be much more exciting for them with wins over Florida and Louisville. And like I said, I think they have an opportunity to maybe beat Tennessee and improve to 8-4. So another good season for the Wildcats, another bowl season. They reach back-to-back goals, bowls. So that's going to be, things will be looking good in Kentucky this season. So please continue to leave likes and comments and subscribe. Let me know what your predictions are for Kentucky or any other SEC team. Leave questions, or if you have a team that you want to see predicted, let me know. And we will see you next time on the Gridiron Expert.